Hello everyone, I'm sorry I haven't done much videos lately, but recently I've been seeing that a lot of people have issues with building their Pokemon, like in EVs, movesets, and stuff like that. I was requested before to make a Charizard X tutorial, but I'm gonna do Charizard and Greninja, try to do them both together, and as you can see on the screen, there's two Greninjas and two Mega Charizards. That means I want to do two different sets, just to let you know your different options that you can run. Now first I want to start with Greninja. Greninja in general, as you can see, his base speed is 122, his base special attack is 103. You probably want to take him in as a special sweeper, probably. He has high speed and high special attack, something really good for a sweeper in general. Now his speed is super high, so if we give it the nature boost on the speed rather than on the damage, by giving it a timid rather than modest, we'll get more out of it. That 10% increase will be more beneficial for us. And as you can see, with full EVs put into speed, he reaches at 377. He's most likely to outspeed almost anybody. And the rest obviously are going to go into his main damage, and that last point we're going to put in health, because you know, you never know when that one health. Yeah, if we want, just set it to level 50 so we can see stats at level 50. 191 the speed, you're almost reaching 200, and by the way, 150 is like the cutoff to be a super speedy Pokemon. This guy has 191, so this guy can do a lot. Now obviously the ability we want to run is Protein, because Protein makes him in a way that any move he uses is going to get a stab bonus, which is an extra 50% damage. So yeah, Protein is the best option you have for him. I don't see any reason to run Torrent at all. Item, Life Orb. Reason we're going to give him Life Orb is because he's speedy enough. He doesn't need any more speed. We want his damage to catch up to his speed, along with his Protein ability, which would give him the damage boost that he needs by making him stab. Life Orb is going to give him an extra 30%. Movesets, it's pretty much the basics. There's Ice Beam. You want to run on him, obviously, for that dragon type coverage. You want to give him a water move. You can use Surf if it's a double doubles, but I prefer the Scald just because of that burn chance. That burn is really good compared to Surf. It's like 10% extra damage, 10 extra power, and hits everybody, including your teammate, versus Scald, which hits one target for 10% less damage, but you're going to give a burn, which can do 1/16 of his health. Kind of prefer the burn, honestly. You want to give him Dark Pulse. Like, these three moves are like a must-have on it, just because Dark Pulse, you can become resistant to Psychic, and pretty much there's Dark is real good with that flinch, and you can return him back to one of his natural types. Now if we look at other options we have here, you can go with Extra Sensory if you want. Extra Sensory gives another flinch, and I think it does the same like Dark Pulse. Yep, they both have the same damage, but the flinch chance differs between the two, so that's up to you. You can, let's see, what else do we have? There's the Scald. I would prefer going with one of the hidden powers, but I'm not gonna tell you to do that, because that is like really, really hard to pull off because of the, you know, get the right IV set and some stuff like that. Yeah, but I would definitely consider Extra Sensory or hidden power, because those are like really the good options you have on him. You have a nice coverage, you have a life orb for an extra boost. It's just a regular, typical, special Greninja spread. This is, even when you're fighting somebody with a Greninja and you notice this is a special sweeper, you're going to be like, probably is going to use one of these four moves. Now, I want to make a different Greninja build. Again, I look at him and I see he's very fast, but if you look at his attack and special attack, his physical attack is only 8 points lower than his special attack. That means I can make something out of it. So if I gave him a Jolly Nature and went full speed with a full physical attack, that 1 point in health, I have a chance to do something. I mean, look, 147 versus the 155, it's really not that much of a difference. Because of his moves that he has, the moves he has as physical is way awesome. There's like so many stuff you can do. You can, if you want, give him a life orb, which is totally fine. Again, we can do that. Rock slide, tell all those Talonflames and Charizards, get out of my turf. You could give him Night Slash. Again, this is like the typical way. I'm going to tell you the way I run it because it's kind of different. Oh yeah, you had Grass Knot for your special. You can use that as well. But anywho, where were the other moves? Waterfall is your main water damage. Nice flinch, nice damage. Overall, that's real good. And usually people run on him Water Shuriken, I think it's called. Yep, Water Shuriken. That's just because of his priority. Now, let me make another Greninja. But this is, we're going to compare it to, can I move? No, I can't move him. Can you move? No. I'm going to compare these two together. And you consider like what you would prefer, but this is like the one that I'm going to be running. I haven't bred him perfectly yet, but this is how I'm going to be running. Obviously, for EVs, I'm going to give him full just the same way with the Jolly Nature, because honestly, that's the best thing you can do. But I want to give him Fling with an item, King's Rock. When you fling a King's Rock, you're guaranteed you're going to be like flinching him. So that's almost like a fake out, but not technically, so it's good. But now I don't have an item, which means acrobatics doubles its power. So I'm hitting a 110 acrobatics with stab because of protein. That is like a real awesome combo right there. If I'm doing doubles, I'll probably run mat block, but I'm not. I'm building for singles right now, so. And obviously, I'm going to put the waterfall, keep that flinch going. That's like always a plus to always have it. You can run here U-turn if you want. U-turn. Just because if you get, we're running against that random Gengar or I don't know who kind of Shadow Tagger, Wobbuffet, Gothitelle, or Gotharita or whatever, which one of that family, you can just U-turn and get out of there. You're faster. And so if they're going to go for a Volt Switch, let's say, with that Rotom, you go for that U-turn, get out, put on Electivire, take that Volt Switch, or put on your Pachirisu or I don't know who with Volt Absorb and gain health or whatever from that Volt Switch. Really good to have sometimes. Your other options that you have are like, you can run like Return if you want. That's a good option. I don't see why you'd run Quick Attack. You can run Shadow Sneak. Shadow Sneak is a great option as well. I think that's an egg move. Not quite sure. Checking Cerebi now. Kalos Region and Greninja. Greninja's egg moves. Oh no, he actually learns Shadow Sneak. He learns at level 23, so probably a Heart Scale move, or while breeding you can give it to him. His egg moves are... Oh, and he actually learns Fling not by a TM, pre-evolution move only, which is good. Oh yeah, and you could give him Smackdown if you want. Destroy a flying type and hit him with an earthquake afterwards. It's up to you at the end. Yeah, back to his egg moves. His egg moves are a water sport. Obviously you don't want it. You can get Toxic Spikes is a good option. I mean, he's fast, you can set up that Toxic Spike and become a poison type if you can, you know, like predict what he's gonna be doing. And get a not very effective, because you would probably live a not very effective attack, but you would not live anything further than that. Mudsport, obviously no. Mind Reader, I don't see why you're going to use that. Camouflage, the user becomes the same type of his environment. I mean, you're running Protein. Bestow, the user passes its held item to the target when it's not holding an item. Again, I don't see the use of it. So pretty much his egg moves are horrid. So unless you want to look at his other, like, TMs. What other options we have other than Toxic Spikes and the return? You could run Feint if you want, but I don't see a reason why you should. Power Up Punch is a good option. I didn't even notice he learned that move. Power Punch, just go in, change to fighting, get that extra boost of attack, and you're even stronger than the special form at that point. This is the set that I'm running right now. Fling, Acrobatics, Waterfall. Probably right now, after seeing Power Up Punch, I'm definitely going to take out my move and put my fourth move and put it as Power Up Punch. I was running Mat Block because I used to run him a lot in doubles, but then I stopped. And I've been getting too many singles requests, so maybe. So this is one way to run Physical Greninja, and this is the cookie cutter style Physical Greninja. I mean, you can still stay on Water Shuriken if you want a priority move. Waster, yep, I can't English. That's up to you. But I really love the acrobatic fling combo that Greninja can do. Now, if we go to Charizard X, again, I want to show two different sets. Put him to level 50. Now we go here. His speed is kind of sluggish. I mean, like, if you give him full, he's barely at the high speed, 152. So I want to give him an extra boost. Obviously, I want to give him the jolly nature. 167, now he's a mess to fight against, because physical attacker with his tough claw ability, he can do damage. This guy, you're definitely, you always want on him is your dragon claw, and you want flare blitz. Those are two good options you have. See, now with his speed and his tough claws, which increases damage by one-third, 33% more just by making contact, and both of these do contact, by the way, you have a really good a way of fighting. You can always put the Protect if you want, just to scout out, and it's kind of good on Charizard X, because unlike Charizard Y, you didn't gain any immunities or anything, you just gained more weaknesses, just for the extra damage. You can also go with the Brick Break if you're having issues with light screen or stuff like that. What I like to run, but this is up to you guys, you can put Iron Tail. Yes, I know the accuracy sucks. Really good against fairies when you really need that. If you're not confident, you can always go with the Metal Claw. Yes, less damage, but more chance to actually hit, and there's a chance you can actually get a physical boost. Physical attack boost on top of it. His attack, obviously you want to put EVs in his attack, which is at 182. So he has a lot of physical damage he can put out. Now, there's another way you can run Charizard X. That's my opinion. I mean, let me just set it to level 50. There's like no reason why one is better than the other, it's just personal preferences. I would give him the adamant nature. Yes, I'm doing something awkward for many. Be like, why are you doing that? probably put in around 130 speed. Now, you'll be looking at that and be like, why are you doing this? Because I want to give him the move Flame Charge. Flame Charge, essentially, if you read it, says, guarantees me going to give me a speed boost. One speed boost is 50%. 50% of 130 is 65. So you're sitting at 195. If you want, just to be on the safer side, right there, 133, that means you're going to guarantee hit the 200 marker. And if you want, put the rest in health. I mean, you can put in defense if you want, or you can put in special defense. Probably off better in health, but defense is also a viable option just because he takes a lot of earthquakes to the face. But now, but this is really risky, I'm going to tell you. You have to know when you can do this. You can't just, like the regular Charizard, just put it in randomly. If you don't want to go with that, you can always go for the Dragon Dance. But I think it's kind of a waste for that setup. But it's up to you. But I just love the Flame Charge just because I can get the high speed 200 and become a menace by myself. Obviously, I'm going to have the Dragon Claw. That's like a guarantee a move I'm gonna have. You can put instead of it the Dragon Rush, but what's its accuracy? Dragon Rush 75% actually, with 20% chance to flinch. You might not want to run it. I run out my Dragonite, its chances of hitting is not bad actually, but it's not reliable if you want to get it as your main damage move, because that accuracy is kind of could throw you off when you need it to hit. So in general, Dragon Claw is better. You can go with Outrage as well if you want. Outrage does more damage than Dragon Claw, so it's up to you, whatever you like. Probably I would run Outrage in doubles team, just because I can guarantee myself with a safeguard that I'm not going to get confused or anything, unless I can put a safeguard with Meowstic, then swap, and then go for the Outrage. I would give him Crunch. Believe that's an egg move. I'll tell you who gives him that egg move in a second. Charizard. Crunch is an egg move, yep. And he gets it from Snorlax, Totodile and his family, what's that guy's name? Tyranitar and his family, Torterra and his family, Garchomp. But not Garchomp's family. I guess he learns it as tutor move. Arbok, Scrafty, Dridigon, Hydreigon and his family, Tyrantrum. You have options. Like, there's a lot of Pokemon that can actually learn Crunch that can breed with Charizard. So that's a good viable option as well. It lowers their defense. You have that staff Flame Charge. Yes, it's not the best move. If you want, you can put another fire type attack move there if you want. That's up to you. You can go for the Fire Punch. Let me see who gives him Fire Punch. I think that is a tutor move, if I believe correctly. Fire Punch, yes, it's a transfer move. You can only get it via transfer. So if you don't have a Black and White, and you don't know how to EV train and IV train in Black and White, then yeah, Fire Punch would be hard to get. But if you can, that's awesome. Can't, oh well. Other options you have is Earthquake. Always have that Earthquake. That's always an extra option for you. More damage, more AoE, very common typing. There's a lot of Pokemon who die to Earthquakes. It's all-round very good. But give you a note, Earthquake does not get a boost from Tough Claws. So, because it does not make contact. Yes, it's physical, but it's not a contact move. Now, if you're afraid of that random guy who's going to be thunder waving you, you can run the facade, you get thundered, or, you know, paralyzed, and you'd be like, just, okay, I'm paralyzed, I'm just going to facade for more damage. If you want another fire move, Fire Fang could be done. Let me see who gives him that move. Fire Fang, he learns at level 28, so yep, that's a good option. He learns it by himself. I don't see any other decent moves if you want to use. I mean, you could go with the Rock Slide just in case you're facing a Charizard Y or whoever. That's always a good another option you can go with. It's a TM, so up to you. You can go with the random Shadow Claw. Decent move, does a high crit chance, and you have Tough Claws, so and it makes contact. If you're afraid of other stuff, you can go with Will-O-Wisp. You can go with Sword Dance if you want instead of Dragon Dance. Like after you go with the Flame Charge, you can get a Sword Dance off. Needs a little bit more setup. I run on it Aurora just in case I get that random Pokemon that's so strong that build up a lot of defenses. Just roar him out and be like, get out of my face. You can run this set, Iron Tail. Instead of Crunch, Bulk Up, not Bulk Up, Hone Claws. That way you increase your accuracy, your Iron Tail will go up, your physical attack will go up. But in this way, you would remove Flame Charge and you want to put him full on speed. Because now you have the speed advantage and you have the extra physical boost. So these are different ideas I showed you, like my concept of using him and other methods and the general way of using him. If there's any other Pokemon you want to know, please let me know. I'm gonna be, if you don't tell me, I'll just choose any random Pokemon and make a build. I hope you guys like this video and hope it helped you guys. Let me know what else, other Pokemon you would like built, and I'll tell you what my ideas are on the Pokemon, how to build them, EVs, items, stuff like that.